My name is Gerald Schufried from the Schufried Company. I run the Schufried Company. This company is based here in Vienna. We have 73 employees, and we develop and distribute psychological tests. And I want to present you today a test battery for the assessment of team players. It's called Success Factors Sport. And we will have a look what are these success factors, to identify them, how we have them identified, how they can be assessed, and how our results look like. If you think of psychological tests, actually many people think of clinical tests, they think of questionnaires such as, let's say, depression or burnout or some personality tests, but this is an important factor, but it's not all. What we focus on are cognitive areas and cognitive tests. Cognitive tests are tests which measure very precisely reaction time, perception speed, reactive behavior, time, movement, anticipation, and so on. And I will show you how we're gonna do this. The main question, obviously, for many people are, for the coaches are, what are the strengths and weaknesses of a player? And we want to have, as a coach, quite an extensive profile of each player. We want to know where, in which areas, in specific areas, he can improve, and what areas might not be that strong, where are weaknesses, and then to think if we work on these factors or on the other factors. And not only about this, because we also want to know, obviously, which where the strength of one person fits best in which area of the team, in order to have the team most effective as possible. And here we have the sports psychology assessment, which this sports psychology assessment should give you all the information that you need to develop the player in the psychological area. So, and when you think very often, it is about the human factor, it is about the psychological factor that makes the difference between good and bad or not successful players and successful and not successful teams. We do this first, mainly obviously just already for players who already are professionals and who already have proven to be successful. But still, we want to assess, to get the profile out of from them in order to improve further. But then a very important additional part is where the tests are used in talent finding. Young players should be assessed if they have a future, how they differ from each other, and again, on which factors we should focus and train them in order that they get successful. We have built out of these psychological and cognitive dimensions four different test batteries, and one is for the motor sport people. One we are talking now is about the team sport. Then we have kids and the teenagers. These are the young child from 12 to, I think, to 16. We have. So as I said before, we have here important factors which are attention, cognitive abilities, reaction behavior, and personality. So again, we focus not only, but also, on not only on personality, but also, and that is very important for us, on the cognitive factors, on attention, and on reactive behaviors of the player. And what we did is, in order to bring these scientific results and the work we did, probably that it can be applied by coaches in the practical world, we developed also what we call fit scores. Fit scores means how does, this is worked out in the result, how well does a player fit for a specific position. And maybe he has, if his fit score is higher as a forward, then as a midfield player, then yeah, we should talk about the player, and maybe probably the, to be a forward is the better position that suits him best. So it should be seen not something as a fact or something which is fixed, but it should be seen as a tool that helps you to talk with the player about his strengths and weaknesses and where to talk on which to work with him on it. Let's have a closer look, please, on the on these four categories which I mentioned. What is attention? Attention is quite a complex field and can be subdivided in many different areas. For the team factors, for people, for athletes working in team, we identified that out of these different factors of attention, the most important is focused attention. Focused attention is the ability of a player to identify between relevant and irrelevant stimuli. So on, even in, if he's under pressure and he must be able to focus on what is important and to be able to not to get distracted. Cognitive abilities is what we have here, what we have picked out of the whole, we had a long battery and we identified these four cognitive abilities are most important in team sport. This is anticipation of movement, memory. Memory obviously is important for learning and to to keep what I have learned and then to use it. Information processing speed, how quick someone can get information and work the information and then adjust his the behavior. And response inhibition. Response inhibition also very important factor. This is to suppress learned behavior if the situation changes. And by this, if someone is, has learned always to do something, a routine, but suddenly the circumstances can change, and then he quickly have to adjust his behavior to these new changes. And that's a very important task, by the way, for the successful players we identified. They have a very good ability to inhibit learned behavior patterns. Then stress tolerance, visual perception, and ability to react, that's the reaction time. And then we have edited some personality factors, which are always important. And yeah, it's from discipline to willingness to help, openness, ambition, and so on. These factors also assessed with this battery. Let me show you to get a better idea how this looks like. Here we have Villeneuve, for example. So we have the tool is it's all on the computer, it's all digital. And for some of the tests, you need to have this panel, as we have it also here, or some additional devices. This would be for peripheral perception. And they have to work on it. And again, a good thing, and the other picture is of the Austrian national team some years ago. They prepared for the European World Cup championship in Austria. And again, the good thing here is for the athletes, they have precise data. And that is what we always see, that is something that athletes want. They want to see facts. And then they want to know, okay, these are the facts. Now I believe what you say. And once I have the fact, I want to know how I can improve. Again, this is always the second step, obviously, what is important for them. How can I get better? Now I have the tests here. This, for example, is a test for short-time memory. Person has to recall symbols, and then later on, in the next slide on the computer, they disappear, and then he has to place them again where they were. This test, for example, that's the one for focused attention. You see digits over here. And again, whenever is a square like this, and they appear and disappear, he has to press a button. So again, This is important to be able to focus and to maintain the focus even in the face of distraction. This is written here. And the absolute the absolute most important test that we have is the determination test. This is the one with the panel, which I showed you. And with this, the person gets different stimuli. They get acoustic stimuli. They get stimuli, visual stimuli. And they have to work on foot pedals. And by this, the system puts the person under stress, because whenever there's a stimuli, he has to respond on the panel that he has accordingly. And the system is programmed in that way that it gets faster and faster and adjusts to the performance of the athlete. And by this, we put the athlete under stress, because at a certain point, he gets to a level where the computer simply is faster than the person. And then it's interesting to see how the person reacts. There are always different kind of reactions. And then some react by frustration. Some react by, they give up. Some totally react confused. And others try to keep up with the situation and continue to work concentrated and to react properly. And then some sports psychologists start to make it even more difficult to let the athletes, for example, run on an ergometer, and they have also to do this, and so on. So you can really very well, also for scientific purposes, adjust the system to the needs that you want.
I have to finish, please.
Then let's have a look at the result. How does it look like? After the test battery, the person gets a report, and here on the report you see again what has been assessed from the attention factors. Then you get the row scores, and then you get here the percentile range. The percentile range says how this person behaved or acted in comparison to other athletes. It's graphically, and here we have the fit scores, which are also calculated. These are overall scores of the individual results. And here you see the maximum is 1,000, and this one got 650. The striker, field player, and goalkeeper. And so we would say, okay, this is all very close. Actually, it has a specific profile, but still it is something here where you can say, well, look here with the athlete, striker would be something that's interesting for you. Do you see it the same way? And so on, you can start to talk with him about these results.